Page 61.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, give thanks to the Lord.
Mercy.
Let us go to him. you had been here, my brother would not have died. But I know that even now, whatever you ask of God, he will grant you. Your brother, said Jesus to her, will rise again. Martha said, I know he will rise again in the resurrection on the last day. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. If anyone believes in me, even though he dies, he will live. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? Yes, Lord, she said, I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who was to come into this world. When she had said this, she went and called her sister Mary, saying in a low voice, the Master is here and wants to see you. Hearing this, Mary got up quickly and went in. Jesus had not yet come into the village. He was still in the place where Martha had met him. When the Jews who were in the house of Isaac and Mary saw her get up so quickly and go out, they followed her, thinking that she was going to the tomb to weep there. Mary went to Jesus. As soon as she saw him, she threw herself at his feet, saying, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. The sight of the tears and those of the Jews who followed her, Jesus said in great distress, a sign that came straight from their heart, where have you put him? They said, Lord, come and see. Jesus went, and the Jews said, see how much he loved him. But there were some who remarked, he opened the eyes of the blind man, could he not have prevented this man's death? Still sighing, Jesus reached the tomb. It was a cave of the stones close to the opening. Jesus said, take the stone away. Martha said to him, Lord, by now he will smell. This is the fourth day. Jesus replied, have I not told you that if you would believe, you will see the glory of God? So they took away the stone, and Jesus lifted up his eyes and said, Father, I thank you for hearing my prayer. I know indeed that you always hear me, but I speak for the sake of all those who stand around me, so that they may believe in you. Lazarus, here, come out. The dead man came out, his feet and hands bound, with bands of stuff and a cloth around his face. Jesus said to him, unbind him, let him go free. Many of the Jews who had come to visit him and had seen what he did believed in him. The Gospel.
Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes, we're called to live our life in the here and now as best we can, faith-filled, no matter what life throws at us, that somehow faith can keep us afloat, carry the empty tomb of how the gospel begins and says, the binding cross of Jesus was still there, and it was almost like a body had come out of him, because he was resurrected. Lazarus was on the tomb, still bound in the cross, because he's not resurrected. Resurrection is our hope. Resurrection is the life forever. It was better than mine being resuscitated. So we'll go by familiar with the medical world now. We can ask people very near the end of life problems, do you want to resuscitate? It's the end of life. Thank you. Son of the living God, all things to come.
Same thing, so the rest of us should sing it all. Pray now, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted to God, the Almighty Father. We pray, O Lord, that just as blessed Lazarus served with devotion your only begotten Son, our Saviour, so we also, through his intercession, may work this our very sacred Christmas. We ask this in the name of Jesus, the Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to God our God.
It is our right and just.
Father, all powerful and ever living God, we do always and everywhere to give you thanks to our Lord Jesus Christ. True man, like us, he wept for his friend Lazarus. God and Lord of life, he called him forth from the tomb. Today, he extends to all humanity his mercy, and with his sacraments, he empowers us to pass from death to life. Through him, the hosts of angels and saints adore you, and contemplate the glory of your works. May we, O Lord, unite our voices to their song in their hymn of praise. Holy,
holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy,
compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout. Thank you.
Let us pray.